Hi, welcome back to My Cup of TV. Jenny,
JD,
and Erin.
Again, welcome back, or welcome for the first time. New band for us. TXT, which is like Tomorrow Together. I know that.
Yeah. Oh, that's cute. I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tomorrow Together.
I know that they're under Big Hit or Hype. I know. we did the Big Hit family photo.
Yeah.
With them and BTS and Lee Hyun, who we still haven't watched.
Yeah.
So I missed it.
You missed it.
I didn't see it.
So we got a little glimpse at them. Mm-hmm. I'm just filling in all the information that I know. I know Subin. And I think he's the sweetest.
I don't remember their names. I remember what they look like.
I remember Taehyung.
I have some of their songs on my playlist, but I don't know as much about them as I do about BTS.
They're aged between 19 and 22.
I just know some of their songs are catchy. Catchy AF. And they're pretty good, yeah. So, but when they first came out, they did come out with this, they came out with Crown, was their debut song, I believe, and they came out with this real cutesy concept, which was, it matched with them at the time, I think.
Yeah.
But then as they've sort of started growing, they've started to release sort of a little bit more grown-up songs, and I think they've wanted to be seen as...
Young men.
Yeah, young men, sort of in their own right. So they went a little bit darker, and then now they're coming out again. Yeah, so they've gone on a journey, actually, I think.
Well, we all went through an emo phase.
Oh, my God, who didn't love the emo phase?
Yeah, the emo phase was great.
But it's good as well, because as we get to go through their videos, we're going to get to see different sides of them, which is nice. Do you know what I mean? So, we're good.
So I've only seen them... It's strange for me, because normally we watch MVs... We get to know the music and then we find out about the band members.
Mm.
Whereas this, we saw a bit of them being them.
Yeah.
Well, I did anyway. You already knew some of their songs before hearing any songs.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a different way around of doing it.
Yeah.
Mm. May I see a photo?
No. And you're going to watch this with your eyes closed.
Okay.
Yeah, of course.
How many?
Five.
Oh, five. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's not... I get a bit nervy on that.
So that's Subin
in
the middle.
Is that blue hair?
Yeah. I know that that's Subin. I know that that's Kai. I know that that's Taehyung. And these two, I know what the names are, but I'm not sure how to pronounce them.
Oh, okay. In a high definition.
Subin, Kai, Taehyung.
Kai's got a very distinctive look. I think Kai might be Japanese.
No, he's got a Korean mother and a Brazilian German father.
That's why he looks different. I know that Kai had a different heritage because he has a unique look.
Yeah.
But I don't... I'm still learning about them. I have not delved into them as much as BTS.
So I saw them for about, like, 10 seconds on a TikTok where you could hear Sugar talking very loudly. Then they could hear it in one of their lives and they were eating noodles.
But yeah, no, I think TXT have done a really good job so far of establishing themselves as a standalone group.
Mm-hmm.
So I like some of their, I haven't got all of their discography, but I've got some of their tunes on my list. And today, I'll choose Puma, which is a really, really good song. And the reason I chose it, because although I love like, I don't know, starting at the beginning, I think with the cutesy face, I don't know, for some reason I appreciate that more when you get to like them and then you go back to their cutesy face, you're like, oh, you like it even more rather than starting with the cutesy face. I don't know why, I just think that Puma's just a really,
you
really
know
good
us
song.
And what is more likely to interest us and get us more interested in TXT, because let's be honest, there are plenty of bands that if the first thing you watch of theirs doesn't appeal to you, you kind of have a bit of is it for me, do I continue, whereas
that's what I mean,
because there's so much to choose from. You think, okay, there's at some point we've got to hit something that we think
at some point
surely they can't all be that magic. Can they? I'm scared.
But it better not be them, because I've seen the thing with them on the Big Hit and they're such lovely guys. So cute.
Well, Puma's kind of, I think now, like in the middle of their discography, so it's a good place to start, and then we can go back to the early ones and carry on. So that's fine. You mentioned Loser, obviously that's their most recent one, but I'm not gonna let you just jump in at the most recent one. That's just greedy. So yeah, we're gonna watch Puma, which is June 2020.
Is there anything we need to, or you can say going in, or is it like a no and then come out the other side? And...
Puma is a song about being afraid to go out into the world on your own, but doing it anyway, having the guts to do it anyway, even though it's scary.
Feel the fear and do it anyway.
Yeah, that kind of thing.
It's a book.
Which I think is good, because it's almost like at the age that they're at, obviously when they're doing this, they could be talking about being scared of going into adulthood. Do you know what I mean? All that responsibility. It's scary, but they're going to do it anyway. And things like that. There could be so many metaphors there of what it could be about. But yeah. But on the face of it, it's just a really enjoyable song. I really like it. It's quite catchy. And aside from their debut image, which was kind of cutesy, this was a new... You know when you get like the comeback and they're like, oh, what's going to happen? And it was a very new style for them. So this was quite an impression.
Almost a rebrand.
Yeah, a little bit, I think. So that's where I found Puma really enjoyable as well. So.
Okay. So please remember to like, comment and subscribe in the comments. What's your favourite TXT song? And why? That's important as well. Why?
Yeah.
Is it that you like the MV? Is it that the song's just too good? Mm-hmm. Is it that your bias has the starring role in that one?
Is the center?
Yeah.
How many biases do you think Jenny's going to end up with by week 3 of TXT?
In about 2 minutes.
Cool. Oh, she's, look at her face. She's already got a bias.
I don't have a bias. I just know who caught my eye.
Mm-hmm.
And again... they're young, so it's like it may be a different type of bias.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It might be they're my favourite, but not like I Am With Sugar. Well, no one's going to be like I Am With Sugar, let's put that out there. No one. But you know what I mean?
I don't know. Just watch this space.
Yeah, west side, east side, get nowhere, the way to go. Tonight, we watch out my candy by me. Love a bit of leopard print.
Oh, sorry, like.
I think it's got glassy floor.
Oh, that looks cool. Oh my god, I'm getting Lion King 2 vibes.
There's a lot I like in this video.
They're pretty awesome.
I need that shirt.
I love the colour of his hair.
Yeah. That's taken. I mean the red hair, I'm assuming.
It was like a purpley red.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's
taken.
Yeah.
I'm not normally one for contacts, but...
it really has a good effect,
yeah,
doesn't it?
I love that, like the climbing up.
You see how they're channeling like caged animals?
Yeah.
Oh. I like that little high pitched.
Mm.
Lion King, Pride Rock.
Very cool.
wait a way to go. No. Tonight be right, jump back, can you buy me some? Oh, you're so tall, but you don't look at my girl, I'm a tall. Oh. West side, east side, it don't matter anymore. Oh, no.
That was so cool.
Where they're breathing.
Mm.
It's like pulsing.
Yeah.
That was cool. It wasn't what I expected it to be.
Mm.
I expected it to be like hard hitting.
Mm.
But it was more smooth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was like dark.
Yeah. Do you see how that would have been for anybody that knew them from their debut that was like a cutesy and then they came out with that? People were like, oh, like they're trying something a little bit more raw and dark. Yeah. So that's why I
chains, cages.
Yeah.
Fire. Yeah. All good things.
Yeah. I love the choreo as well, how they are like channeling those animals.
Feline.
Those,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So I really enjoy
they're
that.
They're like, they're kind of like clawed hands, but without being like, I feel like Gorilla has like ruined, not ruined, but like it's made it so iconic that it's the difficult to incorporate.
They had to use them in a very different way because they had them much lower, didn't they? And almost upright at times.
And almost kind of like balanced, maybe.
So they don't almost, basically, so they don't become like a joke thing.
Yeah.
As it, like it's actually really, really cool choreo. Yeah.
There's a really interesting line. or a couple of lines. It was like, I broke out or I got free and into a world where like...
So I broke out of the cage, the world was alien.
Yeah. Mm. And I was like, that's really interesting if you've been kept in like a certain way or in like a certain attitude.
That would fit with going from childhood to adulthood because you see the world differently once you're an adult.
Mm.
I do sometimes think you must wake protected. Up and you think and suddenly you don't see things the same.
Yeah. Or like you don't see people the same. Do you know what I mean? You can have in particular family members that you've grown up with all your life is a certain way and then once you're an adult and they almost reveal them true selves more than what you do to a child.
Yeah.
And you see them different.
Yeah.
I feel for maybe more specifically for women, but it's at the point in time you suddenly realise that you can't walk along a dark road on your own. You wouldn't maybe think that as a child. You wouldn't realise suddenly it's like, oh, this is how things really are.
The irony is that the cage has comfort of security, but at the same time the cage is a prison. So it's almost like, which do you have? Which do you go for? Because they're both scary. It's scary to stay in the cage and know that that's all there ever will be. Or should I go out of the cage? And
there's risk involved.
Yeah, absolutely,
And how much you fight, actually, as a child, because you're like, oh, I can't wait till I'm this age, or I want to be a grown-up, and oh my God, I want to go back.
Yeah.
So I work with kids, and they were talking about how when you're grown-up, you don't have to go to school. I went to school 9 till 3. Oh, I wish I did 9 till 3.
Yeah.
I'd love to do, like, some homework. And
9 till 3 with a play break and a lunch break, where lunch is provided for you.
Yeah.
I think
with your friends every day.
Mm.
The most underrated thing as like a child is that you just get food given to you.
Yeah.
I mean,
is that what she's given on the verge of tears? You just get food given to you.
No, it's just the idea that for now until I die, I have to think about what I'm gonna eat.
And prepare it a lot of the time.
And no one prepares you for that.
Yeah.
Back in the cage.
Yeah. They should have like life skills classes.
And do you know
what?
Also, once you're an adult, doesn't matter how many letters you write to Santa, he's not bringing you shit.
No, it's true. But if you grow up and get your own job and get some money, you can buy yourself whatever you want, like K-pop concert tickets.
True. I mean, there's the good things.
Yeah, for sure.
The things that you think are going to be good when you're a kid are not the things that are good once you're an adult.
No, that's true, yeah. There has been, I don't believe it's been confirmed, but there's been talk online from like fans and things that say the inspiration for that song as well actually was based on a real puma that escaped from a zoo a few years ago, and unfortunately it had to be hunted down and killed. But again, it was that they were talking about its natural instinct was to get away from the cage and how horrible that was, but at the same time
it's coming to this world where it doesn't know anything.
Yeah, then it comes out and the world is alien and things like that. So it can be, and that's never been confirmed.
But why are you telling me?
Because there's a puma in the background. And it's just food for thought. It's just, yeah, it could actually be legit caged animal, which, yeah, I don't know. That's like we were saying. There's that protection in that, but it's also sad. And so, yeah. But I liked the fact that they, at the end, not only their choreography, but at the end, they actually were like in character. It's like pumas.
Yeah, and the way they were like doing the breathing.
Yeah, because they were all in black.
They weren't, they weren't breathing.
They were moving, yeah. Like they were moving, like they were panting, like they were animals kind of thing. Yeah, yeah. I think it's cool. But they're okay, because they're in a pack. There's five.
They had some really creative choreo, though, as a group. Like, at the beginning, when he climbed up on two of them, or, like, breaking through and pulling them open and, you know, all of that.
Yeah.
They had the arms that were crossing over, and each time he kind of climbed up one rung of arms, like, the next step would almost appear.
Mm.
Like, it's... You know, like, you're in a... Like, you're in a pit. Imagine falling into a pit and you try to climb up.
Yeah.
That's kind of the impression that
And you said about
me.
The Lion King... When you think about it, some of the choreography in, like, Rungs of Ladders and stuff is the sort of thing you see in musical theatre in something like The Lion King, where people are doing stuff like that.
Yeah.
And there's no way, during the making of, that they weren't on that rock holding up Simba.
Yeah.
Simba.
And every cat owner knows, because we've all done it with our cats.
I did it with Jojo this morning. I literally had her this morning, like...
I don't actually think I've done that with my cats. I think they would not be happy about that.
I didn't say he's happy about it.
But oh!
I'm not happy when he decides to try and sleep on my face, but...
Like, these things are just a given.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, the...
There was a female voice.
Yeah, on the on the thingy. I don't know if that was Adora, who's one of the producers at Big Hit. I'm not too sure who that was. Let's see if I can find out.
That was a nice...
Or if you know, let us know. Surprise. But it was. It was really nice, different element for your ears to hear, like during the chorus. It was good. And all the outfits were really, really good as well.
It was... I don't know. It wasn't a slow song. But it's
smooth.
Yeah. Mm. But then, actually, when you think about it, the choreo maybe wasn't so much with how a smooth song would be.
Yeah.
It was a lot of, push and pull, which actually I think goes with the theme of the internal battle that you're going through and the fight for freedom versus being pulled back in. Yeah, do you know what I mean? Because during the choreo, they were, like, very smooth, and then they were jolting, and you know what I mean? So it was a mix of, like, push and pull.
It was very... there must be a technical term for it. I don't know what it is. But it was more than just, like, a choreo dance routine. It was more, like, acting through dance.
Like
a story. Do you know what I mean? Because they were creating images through what they were doing.
I feel like it really was, because they were the animals, not, like... We're not saying it did feel...
They were the animals, they were creating things, like, say, like the ladder and stuff like that.
And that, I suppose the arrows, when all those arrows are shot down, it's like trapped within. And then all the laser light beams, you could argue that's like being trapped as well, tripping it, like, somehow. If you're saying it is this, like, animal kept in a zoo... There are things like that there to keep them.
Try and keep them.
It could also be being an idol. Because you're kept, aren't you, in a certain way, because there's certain things you can't go and do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's that kind of, you want it, but you are restricted.
Yeah. Double-edged sword.
Yeah.
They did say something about, I might just put up the lyrics, but I'm sure it was about, like, the dream or, like, what they wanted to do.
And in a way, for an idol, especially because they go into it so young, once they've made it, the world outside does become a bit alien, because they can't just go out and do normal stuff.
Yeah. As you will see in series like Bon Voyage, when BTS tries to go travelling on their own and things like that, and they don't know how to do it.
And they don't know how to do it, and they're just a bit lost as to how to be grown-ups.
That's right. I don't think there's any... Right or wrong, I think it's all interesting interpretations, which is why I like music so much.
Breaking out of, like, the image as well that was created, which you're saying if this came as like a real stark contrast.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're saying that we're breaking out of that and we're going into this, yeah. Even though it's scary and it's risky, this is what we're doing, yeah. Because there is more security in them coming out as a cutesy band than, you know. So, yeah.
You can't be controversial when you're cutesy.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do we know who wrote... Do they write or have a hand in writing?
I'm not actually sure. Sorry. Let us know.
Yeah. See, we're lucky. As people will let us know this so that the next time we react to them.
Mm. Yeah.
I was able to pick out... Subin had, like, light purple hair.
Mm.
Taehyun had the reddy purple hair.
Mm-hmm.
And Kai had the black hair.
Mm.
And the other two... I can't exactly pick them out yet, and I don't know how to pronounce their names. So yeah, that's actually what I need in the comments. Like, how do I pronounce their names?
I'll need to...
I don't want
to
sit here and butcher
their
names.
And I can,
I feel like admitting I can't pronounce them is nicer than sitting here and butchering them.
Yeah.
If I have them in Hangul, then I'll read them for you.
Well, if I could write them in Hangul, I'd be a lot further along.
Well, I mean, I'll look at them on my phone after.
Okay.
That's not what I was expecting.
No, I was expecting something more hard-hitting, but I did like it.
Yeah. It's kind of the sound's playing in my head, but it's like further in the back of my brain, almost like a haunting melody.
Yeah. And there's something kind of slightly sad about that song. With that story, that interpretation, but yeah. It's a catchy song. It'll grow. I promise you it'll grow on you.
Yeah. Piqued my interest.
Okay, so that was TXT Puma. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one. Bye!
Are you looking for gift ideas? Here are some K-pop merch. They are perfect gifts for your friends, your family, and yourself. They offer worldwide shipping. They have a very wide selection of many merch. Such as BTS merch, Stray Kids merch, cute aesthetic merch, anime merch, and many more. They have amazing prices and sales, great for everybody. Just click the link in the description.